Hey everyone, welcome back to the Boxica podcast. It's Cyrus. I'm here again with Claire.
Hello.
She remembered to say hello this time. And today's episode is all about mindset, okay, and how the mindset relates to everything we're trying to do, training, fitness, being in shape, good nutrition. And yeah, and I just want to start this off by saying that I personally believe and know that mindset is the single most important aspect to all this, because the process of being on point with your nutrition and the process of coming to the gym and training is not that difficult, right? It's very mechanical. Eat the right stuff, train regularly, you'll look good, you'll feel good, you'll be a fit and healthy person. But in reality, you know, putting that into our everyday lives, it's not that easy or simple due to the mindset. So it is, in my opinion, the most important aspect of this whole journey. So, Claire, I'll have you kick this off.
Yeah, okay. Mindset. Yeah, you're right. It is very important, because going to the gym, following your nutrition plan, it's all very mechanical. You just have to take action and do it to see those results. But I think if you spend too much time focusing on the outcome, you know, you can constantly feel that you're just, you know, you're focusing so much on results and not actually enjoying the process and growing, like, on a, you know, I don't mean body-wise, I mean on a personal level.
Yeah.
And I think, yeah, I think you need to enjoy the journey and every day learn something new from it, because it really is, this is for the rest of your life. You know, it isn't just a 6, 8, 12-week thing. It's, you know, you get one life. You know, you want to be healthy. Fitness is health, it's performance, it's strength, it improves your brain function. It's not just about bodybuilding.
Yeah, it's not about just looking good and being
strong
in the
gym.
It's
just about moving your body and growing on a, like, personal level and enjoying the process.
Enjoying the process is a big one. If you're doing something and you're miserable doing it, you know, what are you doing? There's something going wrong there. But yeah, there's a few sides to that. I mean, you know, the other side of it is, you know, sometimes when you are building new habits, if you've spent years building habits that have caused you to gain body fat and be unfit and unhealthy, it's going to be tough. Some aspect of changing those bad habits is going to be tough. And having the right mindset from the start and understanding the journey is a big one. So when I've coached people with nutrition, a lot of people get frustrated. They get frustrated with the speed of the results.
Yeah,
and that's a mindset thing. You have to understand that it's a long old journey. Like you just said, it's the rest of your life doing it. So if you kind of, like, I'd say, like, let's talk about this like as a journey. You start in your plan, you've got your nutrition plan, your training plan, as you said, and it's very easy to get results from that. You just follow it and you know, 3, 6, 12 months time, you'll be looking better than when you started.
But you're probably not going to be happy.
Yeah. And
because then you go, okay, well, what's next?
Yeah.
Because you've just focused on the result.
Yeah.
And not, you know, you're not the process.
Mm. Yeah.
So you're constantly chasing that satisfaction, which is a short-term feeling, rather than chasing fulfillment, because it's chasing that fulfillment is where you grow in.
Yeah. I feel as well like the people, like you just nailed it by saying you're chasing the result, and the people that chase the result don't hold on to it for long.
No.
They don't. They're not embodying the journey, the process, the lifestyle thing, you know, live a fit and healthy lifestyle, look like a fit and healthy person. They're just aiming for that result they're likely miserable when they're doing it, but even if they're not, when they reach that goal, then stuff starts to happen, bad habits start to creep back in. And so it's like at the start of the journey, recognizing that it is a lifestyle and you're on this train for the rest of your life. And that's really the beginning mm-hmm. of the mindset journey, just understanding that not every day is going to be perfect. If I am trying to lose body weight, some weeks I will lose weight, some weeks I might gain weight.
Yeah.
This is the way it goes.
It's all a part of it.
Yeah, so it's just a recognizing in the beginning that, okay, this is not just an overnight thing for me. This is a lifelong journey, and I need to be happy doing it. And I need to, you know, get... So the mindset in the beginning of the journey is like this, right? It's just like... appreciating that it is going to be hard sometimes, it is a lifelong thing, and there's no shortcuts or easy ways to get in shape. It's just that steady, consistent progress. And
you've got to do the work.
Yeah, and then inevitably, once you start the journey, you will hit roadblocks mindset-wise. I mean, I don't wake up every morning and feel, you know, super motivated to train. And the excuses will roll in, and you know it's just about the habits is a big thing that I talk about, building the habit. It's not just about the physical habits, it's the mental habits as well, and letting them take over in a way. Sometimes I'd say at least 30% of the time before I work out, I don't really want to work out. I'm like, I can think of 1,000 other things I could be doing right now. And I never, ever, ever regret doing a workout once I've done it.
No. I always say, if you're ever feeling unmotivated, because, yeah, we're not, we don't jump out of bed every morning like, woo, ready for the day. You know, even the most positive people, you do have days where it feels more of a grind. So the way I look at it, whenever I'm going to do a training session, if I'm not feeling motivated, I say to myself, right, I'm going to go in and I'm going to do my first two exercises of the day. Mm. If after the first two exercises, I'm not feeling it and I'm just like, no, this is not feeling it today, then I walk out the gym. But the chances are, once you're in the gym, you've got those first two exercises out the way.
Yeah.
You're like, actually, no, I'm going to do this.
That's perfect.
And it works every time.
Yeah. You never leave, right? Or once in a blue moon.
Yeah, I've left a couple of times, but
yeah,
you know, it's a really good way to, and it is. That's just a mindset thing. It's changing your mindset to
get in the gym, start working out. As soon as you start sweating and you start moving, there's no regrets to being in there. But the mindset will hold you back in the beginning, getting yourself to the gym. Like I just said, sometimes, like some of the times, all the things that I could be doing rather than training start hitting your mind. And I feel like around, talking about the journey again, if you've just started on the journey, I feel around the 6 to 8 week mark, that's like a point that I've seen in my experience with clients where it's like make it or break it kind of territory. Mm. Always 6 to 8 weeks. You know, lost a bit of weight. I'm happy with it, but taking it to that next level, old habits start creeping in, demotivated for whatever the reason is. You know, a lot of the times when you get something in your mind like this, it literally just is in your mind. Like, it's not an actual obstacle or, you know, thing that's going to stop you from reaching your goals. It's just it's just the old habits just creeping in there. You get a little bit complacent with things. One day turns to two, turns to three, and this whole thing. And that falling off the wagon is all due to mindset.
But I think as well, that comes down to, I look at it like this. If you don't enjoy something or you don't enjoy what you're doing, it's not yours.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it's not for you.
Yeah.
You're not listening to, your body. You're not listening to what you want. Mm. So if you go into the gym and you're not enjoying it, you know, 6-8 weeks down the road, it's not something you're going to continue with. And then what's going to happen? You're going to fall off the wagon. You're going to stop going to the gym. You're going to stop with your nutrition plan, and then all those limiting beliefs of self-doubt and, you know, saying you're going to do something and then you're not doing it.
Not following
you, you're just fueling all that self-doubt, yeah. all those limiting beliefs. And then you're going to have that fixed mindset where you're like, okay, well, yeah, this isn't for me. I knew I wasn't going to be able to stick it.
Yeah.
And that is all mindset. So if you don't enjoy going to the gym, that's okay. Like, find something else.
Yeah.
That, come to Boxica. Right. Everyone loves Boxica. But find something that you enjoy. You might just like doing yoga, and that's okay.
Yeah.
You're moving your body, you're building strength, flexibility.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be the gym.
Yeah.
It could be anything that involves moving your body.
Mm.
Because it's everybody needs to move in some way.
I feel like people set themselves up for failure in the outset because they put, you know, they expect that in order to get the results, they need to be perfect all the time. And so they say, yeah, I'm going to train 6 days a week. I'm going to be perfect on my diet every day. And then in 4 weeks, I'll hit my goals and I'll be happy. And that's just setting you, that's just not realistic.
No.
You're setting yourself up mentally to crash at some point. So it goes back to what you said in the beginning, enjoying what you do, taking a deep breath, take a step back. I don't need to train 5, 6, 7 days a week. Just chip at it 3, 4 days a week over time. And, you know, the results will happen. And another thing is, like, I feel like, well, I know because I've done this before as well. If you extend the period, like if you take a 2 weeks off, for example, if a bad day turns into two bad days, turns into five bad days, turns into, you know, 10 days, you start seeing your body impacting negatively, you know, you're gaining fat. And that is just the worst position to be in. Like getting back on the wagon after that is very difficult to do. It's very hard. I've done it myself so many times, like, you know, it just rolls on and it rolls in, and then getting yourself back, you know, you look yourself in the mirror, you feel demotivated. Oh my God, I've gained so much fat. You know, then at that point, you know that going back to the gym is going to be difficult because it's going to be painful. Like going back into a workout, you're going to get the DOMS again and the whole thing. And if you've been off the wagon for 2 weeks, it's going to take at least 4 weeks to get back to where you were at the start. So a big thing is, like, and I say consistency all the time, but
prepare, you know, for the roadblocks.
Yeah, even if you train twice a week, that's not bad. Like, people think that's bad. Like, oh, only twice a week? No, that's good. You train twice. That's amazing.
It's not, you know, training six times a week. If you're 1 week only, you know, getting two out of your six training sessions, and then the following week only three, and then you're getting six, it's not ideal. You know, the best plan is one that you can stick to, that fits into your lifestyle, and one that you can stay consistent with.
Yeah.
Because it's chipping away at that over a long period of time.
Yeah.
Which creates results.
If you plan for two workouts a week and you do an extra third workout, amazing. Bonus.
Yeah.
You're doing more than what you planned. So pat yourself on the back. Well done.
And that also gives you that confidence.
Exactly.
And builds that momentum to want to keep going.
Yeah, I love what you said about not trusting yourself.
Mm.
Like, fueling the thoughts of, like, oh, here we go again.
Yeah, I'm not doing what I said I was going to do.
I said I was going to do this, and I'm not doing it again. So you're not trusting yourself again. So your mindset starts flying all over the place. That's a big one. Like, trusting yourself. Like, knowing that if you're... So set yourself up for success before you even start, and know, and, like, again, repeating myself, know that it is going to take time and it's not going to be perfect, and don't be too hard on yourself, and that, I think that keeps your mindset in a realistic position and helps keep you on track as well.
And don't compare yourself to others.
Oh.
You know, everyone is on their own journey, you know, has different roadblocks, different issues, you know. You can only be as good as you were yesterday. You know, focusing on yourself and not anyone else is key as well.
That's a really good, great advice. only focusing on yourself.
Yeah. And, you know, praising yourself for what, you know, you've achieved. That's why I really like nighttime journaling, because I think it's, you know, again, waking up in the morning, spending 5 minutes to, you know, write what you're grateful for, get some clarity on your day, set your intention. And then at the end of the day, you just reverse it, you know, 5 minutes, a bit of nighttime journaling, reflection on your day, you know, and it, you can really pinpoint, you know, what you did well today, what you feel like you could improve on tomorrow. And, you know, most importantly, how are you feeling? Mm. You know, are you happy? Are you feeling good? Did something happen? Mm. You know, because if you've done something that's not feeling good, then again, like I said, it's not yours, and you're just pushing, you're pushing resistance, and you're just going to stay stuck in this fixed mindset. Mm. So it's almost like you're freeing yourself, like you're freeing your mind.
Yeah. I feel like sometimes we're really not in touch with what we really actually want.
We're not in touch with our inner being.
Yeah, yeah, we're not. We're like going...
We're
going
just autopilot every day.
Yeah, and then you kind of subconsciously a little bit, you feel like something's not right here.
Yeah.
But you don't really address...
No, you just keep pushing and pushing, and, you know, and it's getting to that that, you know, creates this positive mindset.
Yeah, yeah. No, that's big.
An alignment.
So is there anything that you do in a day that you've just mentioned, journaling, like, is there anything else like that that you do that is for like a positive mindset? Like, do you just go through?
So I like to throughout my day, if I feel like I'm, you know, having negative thoughts, or I'm thinking about, you know, something that's happened yesterday and not today in the present moment, if I feel like I'm spending too much time thinking about that and those thoughts, then I actually just like do a little check-in with myself and go, okay, I need to change this, turn it into a positive. And it's just changing how you talk to yourself, because you know, you're responsible for your thoughts, your feelings, your actions, your choices, everything. You know, it's up to you to change it. And that's why it's not just about going to the gym and training your body. Like, you have to train your mind as well. Yeah. Throughout the day, you know,
checking in with yourself.
Check in with myself. It's a work in progress. You know, I'm constantly, I love personal development, and I'm always looking for ways to, like, improve myself personally and, you know, with my work as well. And, I just think it's really important.
Quick question. Have you read The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle?
Yes.
This book is unreal. That's probably the single... I've read a lot of books, by the way. Like, lots of books. That's probably one of the single most important books that will always stick out. And I read it, like, 3-4 times. Because it just had such a profound impact. Like, almost every paragraph in that book, or the first time I read it, or listened to it in audiobooks, I was like, wow! So it was all, like, this new stuff that completely made sense to me. And I was just like, going crazy with this book. And I read it again and again and again. And I'll check in. I'll try and do one time a year. I'll reread it just to remind myself.
Yeah.
And something you said there, like, not being in the present moment. This is a big one for me. My mind will wander to either the future or the past, and it will impact my current mindset and
it's
my
distraction.
Mood.
Yeah.
Yeah. And really, it's just about now, because that's the only time. That's the only thing you've got. There's no past, there's no future, like, you are now.
And there's a really good way to get into the present moment as well. Like, if you don't feel grounded. So a good way to feel grounded, this might sound a bit crazy, but if you just go out into, like, nature, the grass, which you do. I've seen your little feet on the ground. Your pictures.
My little feet? They're not that little. No, go on.
They are for a guy. I think they are.
They say about little feet.
But bare feet. We'll save that for another day. Bare feet on the grass or just like at the beach, whatever. But just really just grounding yourself. And, you know, if you're thinking about yesterday or, you know, you want to bring yourself back to the present, you just have to make everything, okay, what am I feeling? What am I thinking? What am I seeing? What can, you know, and there's all these little things that you can do to just bring yourself back to the, just like lying on the grass. You know, you just connect in, you ground in, just focusing on your breathing. And that's why moving your body is so important, because we just keep all this tension in our body because we just go every day. So by, you know, daily movement, you're actually just releasing all of that. That's why stretching and mobility is so important, because, you know, you're almost like freeing up your body of all these tensions and this tightness, and which can all affect your overall mood as well, and your mindset.
I feel like exercise brings you back into your body as well.
Yeah.
Because you're feeling the, you know, how painful it is, or you're breathing heavy, and you are in your body when you're training.
Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons why I'm addicted to working out. Anything that can focus my mind on that moment.
Yeah.
I love it.
It's like meditation, isn't it?
It is meditation.
You know? And that's why when I did jiu-jitsu, that's what I loved about jiu-jitsu, is for that hour, you are completely in the zone.
Yeah.
You're in the present moment, because you don't want to get choked.
Yeah.
So you have to be in the zone.
For sure.
Otherwise you're gonna get choked out.
No, 100%.
So you come away from there and you feel like you've had, you know, a full hour of just not thinking about work,
crazy, right?
Life, everything.
Yeah. For sure, like jiu-jitsu is one of the most extreme versions of that. It's like you don't have a choice to think about other things, because you feel like you're trying to stay alive, like when you're rolling and someone's trying to put their arm around your neck and stop you from breathing, which happens multiple times in a session. And that's like an extreme version of like being in the moment. Meditation for me, like typical meditation is really good. Like I felt the benefits, but it's very difficult to do.
Because it requires patience. I'm the same. You know, I would much prefer to just
go for a run,
lie down, just focus on my breathing, you know,
yeah,
move my body like in a flow,
yeah,
like flowy stretches, because meditating it requires patience.
A couple of things that are in the book. Okay, I know some people that are listening to this are not gonna read Eckhart Tolle's book, The Power of Now, but there's two things that really stick out for me, which helped me to this day. By the way, have you heard of the Landmark Forum?
No.
The Landmark Forum. No, I did the Landmark Forum. I can't remember when it was, before COVID, and it literally changed a lot in me. I'll tell you the quick story.
Yeah.
I was reading a book by the founder of Lululemon.
Oh, okay.
The clothing brand, right?
Yeah.
The fitness clothing brand.
I love Lululemon.
Yeah. It's so expensive, but it is good. I feel like the quality's gone down a bit. They don't, like, they've started putting, like, big Lululemon, like, logos and stuff on some of their stuff. I don't like that. But anyway, I digress. in this book, the founder of Lululemon, this one guy started it, said that he did the Landmark Forum and it changed his life. And he learned the things he learned on the forum. He said he'll always look at his life as before the forum and after the forum. And I was like, wow, if this billionaire guy that seems to have it all together is saying this about this thing, I need to do it. And it was like a weird thing. Like I went online, I saw they had one in Dubai like a few weeks later. I paid for it and I just didn't know anything. I didn't research it. They called me before the call. I was like, yeah, I'm busy. I'm just going to show up, blah, blah, blah. And I thought it was a business coaching course. So I went there thinking like, like going to get some good insights and, you know, going to learn about this stuff. And
it was very personal.
My God. Like, I sat in this room and I was like, oh my God. Like, it really, like the first, I think it's like 3 days, full on days, morning to evening, like 8 a.m. to like 10 p.m. or whatever. And then you do a fourth night. So really, it's just the 3 days.
Yeah.
The Landmark Forum, it turns out, millions and billions of people around the world have done it. It's been going since the 80s or the 70s.
Right.
And I don't know, they just do this thing where they break you down. They break you down. And they say this stuff. And the first day, you're kind of going through it.
You're resisting, you're like, no, I'm not breaking.
You're like, no, I don't like this, this way, this thing. And then you go home and you're like, it's okay. And I almost didn't go back the second day. And then I did the second day, and then on the third day, they talk about this moment.
Yeah.
They say at 5 p.m., they're exact with it, you're going to have a breakthrough.
Yeah.
And at like 4:50, you've been sat in this chair for like 3 hours for this one lecture, and it's getting intense. Like, it's getting intense.
Yeah.
But you're like, and at 5 p.m. on the dot, the pin drops.
Yeah.
And everyone just goes, people start crying, you get, my hairs are standing up just thinking about
it. Yeah, yeah.
And you're just like, oh my God. And I don't know how they do it. I mean, it's crazy how they do it. There's no phones allowed. There's no note taking. They just break you down. They make you realize something, and then you're never the same person again.
Did it feel like that one moment, everything up until that day, just everything made sense now?
100%. That's exactly.
Yeah.
And I tell people, the way of explaining it is, it's like getting a mirror and looking at it and looking at why your personality is the way it is.
Yeah.
Because you don't know. You just go around your day and you're just doing your stuff. Why are you like that? Why do you make these decisions? Why?
Yeah.
And it's like looking at yourself properly in a mirror and actually seeing who you are and why who you are. So like, the thing is, you don't need to be that person anymore. You had an incident when you were 8 years old and you built these...
Stories
in your mind. You haven't done it, right?
No,
because stories is a big thing.
And you build but I'm interested in personal development, so
right. You build up these stories around it. It's not the reality, it's just what this 8-year-old, you know, kid has done, like a mechanism or whatever, and you carry that into adulthood.
It's your conditioning.
Yeah. This course, this Landmark Forum, is looking at it, and you're like, oh my God. And obviously you're on a high for about a week after it, and you're just like floating around life, but things kick back in, but something always stays with you. And the little voices of the course leader that takes you through it will just pop into your mind now and again, or you'll realize, oh my God. And so back to my original point, 2 points that I got from the book, which is same as the Landmark Forum, is with mindset that have helped me a lot. The first one is that voice inside your head that doesn't stop is not you.
Let's flick it off.
Just get up. That voice, you can't stop it, and it's not you.
So you have to change the way you think about it.
Well, it's understanding that you've always got a voice inside your head and that it doesn't shut off.
Mm.
And because we've built up, it's a defense mechanism in the mind, it's to help us survive, right?
Mm.
Oh my God, watch out for this, watch out for that, watch out for this. Oh my God, this is coming. You know, back in the day when we were evolving, you know, tens of thousands of years ago, wild animals, whatever it would have been, right? We've developed this thing.
Yeah.
Recognizing first that that's not you, and it's going to hold you back in life. Like, it's going to say, oh, you know, fear, what? Don't go for that job. Don't do this fitness program. Don't do that because X, Y, Z, it's going to try and stop you and hold you back. So recognizing that voice inside your mind, you know, you might be trying to do something, or you're on a fitness program, you're being, you know, a lot of negative thoughts are coming in. That is not you.
Yeah.
And how do you know it's not you? Well, you can hear the voice. You can take a step back and be like, huh, there's that voice again. So it's not you, because you can separate yourself from it and realize that this thing won't shut up. And then you can recognize that it's mostly negative. So the first thing I got from the book, The Power Now, and the Landmark Forum, is that voice isn't you.
Mm.
And you don't have to listen to it. You can't shut it off. It's always going to be there. But you can recognize it and go, okay, thanks for that thought. But no, I'm good. I'm going to do what I want to do here and do that. And then the second thing, because I feel like that voice impacts a lot. Like, tells you not to go training, tells you, oh, just, you know, yeah, it's fine, just eat that, whatever yeah. it is. No, you don't need to track your calories. No, you don't need to go training today. No, you don't need to sleep. You can just stay up and blah, blah, blah. Like, it's a lot of negative stuff. And like I said, anything you want to go for in life, it kind of holds you back. And then the second thing that I got from the book and the forum is, or mainly from the book, is if you are feeling overwhelmed and you've got voices going on and you're just negative thoughts, crazy, and you're just having a bad day, and like you said, what you do is just kind of like take a rest and put your feet on the floor and chill. Yeah, mine is putting my mind into my body.
Yeah.
Like feel, like you don't, it sounds weird to say, but like feeling your hands, like feeling that you're in your hands. Right?
Yeah.
And you're feeling your hands and you're like, oh, okay, there's my hands. Okay, yeah, that's weird. And then you're like, oh, there's the toes. Okay, yeah, no, that's weird. Oh, my legs. Oh, okay, cool. And you go, lungs are moving in and out.
That's what I was saying about bringing yourself back to the present moment by stating the obvious, you know, by, oh, I can feel my hands. You know, and just taking you away from that overwhelm, anxious, just to get yourself.
Yeah.
Because you have to protect your energy as well. And
in the moment. Just being in the moment 100%. And I feel like that's like a big, it's like taking all that negative energy and just like dumping it away when you become into the present and you realize, that was just all in my mind. Wow. Amazing.
And that takes practice as well. That's something that it's a daily ongoing thing. It's not something that can just change overnight because you've been conditioned to that way of thinking for, you know, your whole life. So that's why I think mindset is so, so important. And it isn't just all about going to the gym because you want results.
Yeah.
You know, the whole thing works together.
Yeah. No, there isn't a healthy body without a healthy mind.
No.
It's linked. It's all linked together. And you can have a good looking body without a healthy mind or you know, you can, you know, get the abs or whatever and be ripped, but that doesn't mean you're in a good place.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you're in a good place mentally or physically, because you can look good and still be unhealthy. So, yeah. Wow, that's a good one. I wasn't expecting this podcast to go into the forum, but it's such...
No.
We could probably sit here for like hours and we could do like another 5 podcasts on mindset. It's so important. But I think small takeaways and things that we've spoke about today is, again, recapping... realizing that it is a lifelong journey and setting yourself up for success in the beginning by not being too hard on yourself and mentally preparing for an up and down journey. Because at the end of the day, that's what it is.
Yeah, because you throw little niggles and injuries in there. Oh. That's going to set you back, and then that's going to affect your mindset.
It's going to make
but
you
But we'll save that
horrible.
One for another day.
Yeah, injuries. We'll do another one on that. But no, for sure. A little thing, but an injury could be anything, right? Could be, you know, family member sick or something was supposed to happen or financial issues and all these kind of things nip away at you mentally.
Well, you can let that injury, you know, I'll just quickly, when I hurt my back... you know, at first I thought, okay, this is either going to put me in negative headspace or I can turn this around and go, okay, what can I do?
Yeah.
So when I went to see the back specialist and she told me my injury, that's the first thing I said. She said, you cannot compete anymore with Olympic weightlifting.
Yeah.
And I said, well, what can I do? Yeah. And otherwise I would have just let that.
Yeah.
And, you know, it took time to, you know, some days you get frustrated with the injury because you want to do things, but you just have to turn it around. Okay, what can I do? What are the positives from this? Mm. And a lot of positives did come from it. So, you know, when you do get injured, it's the first thing people do. Oh, I can't go to the gym. I've hurt myself. And it's the wrong thing to do because there are so many things you can do to work around injuries.
Yeah.
It's about just keep pushing forward, and that's a typical roadblock.
Yeah, no, 100%. And that injury could be anything.
Yeah.
Are you going to use that as an excuse to be miserable? And are you going to focus on that? Or you said the perfect thing. What can I do?
Yeah, and what are you going to learn from that? Because there's always something you're going to learn from it.
Yeah, and you can always improve in other areas.
Yeah.
And I feel like you get...
That's how I got so good at pull-ups.
Yeah. Honestly, I feel like you get what you need.
Yeah.
I feel like sometimes things come to you in life and it's like, damn, you're so destroyed in the moment, but when you look back at that situation, you're like, ah, oh, I can see why that happened.
Yeah.
I got this out of it. You can always get something from a seemingly negative situation.
Yeah. Like,
injuries are not fun. I've had my fair share of shoulder surgeries, back issues, neck issues. And it causes me now to take a step back and go, right, something's not right here. Like, I'm getting this for a reason.
Yeah.
I need to, you know, work on something else, focus on something else. What can I do? Maybe there's something else. You know, a lot of the thing is people get injured in this example. They're not doing the other things that are required. So you can be a fit and healthy person. Are you doing your stretching? Are you doing your sleep? It's usually something's happened for a reason, right? You're not doing something properly. So you need to take a step back. Maybe you're too busy, or, you know, you're not focusing on these things. You're not staying hydrated. You're not eating good with the injury thing. So, yeah, going back to the first point was just like realizing it's a lifelong journey.
Yep.
Don't be too hard on yourself. No one's perfect. Set yourself up for success in the beginning. And then you mentioned bring yourself back into the moment when the mindset kind of goes on a mad one.
Yeah, when we're on autopilot.
Yeah.
You know, just bring yourself back to the present and...
Yeah, well, exactly. Like feeling your body, realizing that those negative thoughts are not really you. Well, they're not you, full stop, they're not you. So you can recognize they're there and be like, yeah, thank you very much, but nah, I'm not going to listen to you today. I'm going to carry on with this, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
Taking a deep breath, bringing yourself into the moment. I feel like that advice is amazing when you feel like, you know, when you get that feeling sometimes like you...
anxious and overwhelmed.
Yeah, or you see a food item.
Yeah.
And you get that split, F it, I'm going to do that. And then actually, if you take a deep breath and you be like, no, is that going to support my goals and everything?
Is it worth it?
I guarantee like 90% of the time it won't be worth it.
And it all comes down to what we talked about before with that short term satisfaction. You know?
Can eat that thing. I'm picturing a carrot cake here.
Yeah.
You can eat that thing now. I mean, there's ways to eat carrot cake and not destroy your goals, right? Which you talk about, which is tracking your food and making sure that you stay within your energy balance for the day. But let's say that this carrot cake is going to take you over your calories for the day. I've also got a solution for that. Just take a bit of the...
Yeah.
But let's just imagine that this carrot cake for a second is going to pull you off your goals. It's going to make you off track. I guarantee like 90% of the time, you take a deep breath and you'd be like, I don't need this. Like, it's not supporting me. I'm not going to do it. But the other 10% of the time, hell yeah, this thing is worth it. And I'm going to smash this thing right now. And I'm going to enjoy every piece of it. And I'm not going to feel guilty and amazing. But that advice of like taking a deep breath and being like...
asking yourself why... If you want to eat it for the right reasons, then go ahead, enjoy it. Because, yeah, this is a lifestyle. It's not a overnight thing.
Yeah.
But if you're doing it out of, you know... to suppress an emotion, then that's different.
Big
you know,
one.
So it's again, it all comes down to that mindset and checking in with yourself, and you know, just asking yourself,
food is
why do you want that?
Food is great, and we all enjoy food. But if you use food to make you feel good all the time, that's a problem.
Yeah,
like I'll eat a carrot cake and feel amazing after it, or while I'm eating it. Yeah, great, but I'm not going to use that carrot cake
to make yourself feel better.
Yeah, that's wrong.
We're not animals. Like, we don't need treats. You know, we're not...
yeah.
Oh, and that's why I don't like it when, you know, people will say, oh, I'm going to have that because I deserve it.
Yeah.
It's like, you're not an animal. You don't need to have your treats.
You don't need to
deserve it. You don't need to deserve
it.
You want to eat it, eat it.
Yeah.
I've worked so hard this week, so at the weekend I'm just going to... eat whatever I want.
Yeah.
Like, you don't need to be rewarded.
Yes, 100%. Yeah, and no, it is. It all comes down to the lifestyle thing.
Yeah.
Like, live the lifestyle. Yeah, you don't want to live for the weekends, for sure. Checking in with yourself. I feel like, just one more on that point, like checking in with yourself. I feel like just breaking the urge with a pause, because you're on automatic pilot, like you said. And Keith's here. just tell Keith,
hi, Keith.
2 minutes, we'll be done. We're finishing up. I feel like, let's say the carrot cake example, right? Negative or whatever, thoughts kick in, eat it. You can immediately grab something and put a bit in your mouth, right? And then you're in.
Yeah.
Like, once you've had that first bite,
there's no going back.
You are in. Like, you can't eat half of it and move away. So I feel like to break, like you said, perfect, stopping, putting the fork down, and just waiting. I honestly feel like give it like 20 seconds, and you'll probably realize within that 20 seconds, nah, not today.
But it's also, if you are clear on your goals and like your vision and what you want to achieve and what you're working towards, then no, that's going to help because that's going to stop you from.
For sure.
But if you're unclear on, you know, what your why is, why you're doing this, what you want to achieve, you know, if you're not striving for that progress.
Oh yeah, you easily taken off track.
Yeah. So again, it's all mindset.
Clearly defining your goals, getting your mind in the right place. Right, this is what I want to achieve. I think I said it on another podcast. Maybe I said it on the first one. I can't remember. Writing. This is what I do. I have my goals. If I just show you my phone, I have obviously 1,000 people trying to WhatsApp me. But if I just show you this. I have my goals written on my phone, on my screensaver.
Yeah.
Boom, right there. Every morning when I wake up, grab my phone, read my goals. Before I go to sleep at night, I read my goals, and I do that every single day. And that is a big one for staying on track. Because your goals then, if you do, like you said, you have your clearly defined written down goals, and you read them every morning and every evening, they are constantly in your mind.
Yeah.
And I am a big believer in having... If you want to achieve something, have your mind in that place first. So, like, let's talk about getting in shape. A lot of people, when they look at their body and they think about their body, it's not a positive thing. It's not, yes, I can do it. Oh, I can get in shape. Wow, I look great. And if you're looking at yourself every day in the mirror and you're being like, oh, I look like shit. You know, this is horrible. Look at my body. I'm fat. Blah, 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 blah. Every day saying those things over and over and over. Guess what? That's not, you're not setting yourself up for success there. You're reinforcing what you don't want by focusing on what you don't want.
Yeah.
That's not the right place to be mentally. Get your goals down. Start imagining. Start thinking about, you know, and I've watched The Secret and I've read The Secret. Have you read The Secret?
No.
The Law of Attraction. Have you heard of the Law of
Attraction?
Yeah. So Law of Attraction, you know, I think it's very misleading, The Secret, the movie.
Mm.
You'll have to watch it if you haven't seen it or read the book at least. Like, it's almost like you think about something in your mind and magically it just appears in the universe for you. I do not believe in that. Right? That's nonsense. But I do believe in having something in your mind daily, like writing down your goals and being very specific and reading it daily. Like, that's in your mind. So, you know, it's in the back of your mind. It's in your subconscious.
Yeah.
So you look at that carrot cake, for example, and you're like, nah, immediately.
You could even ask yourself, what would the new me do right now?
There you go.
What, you know, and that's how you can flip those negative thoughts.
Would fit and healthy Claire eat that carrot cake?
Yeah. So you have to bring yourself, you have to remove away from those bad habits, what you've been doing up until now, and to, you know, change.
Yeah.
You have to, like, see yourself, where do you want to go?
Yeah.
You know, what does the new you look like?
And what does that new you eat? Right?
Are you going to do it? Would that new you eat that carrot cake because you've had a rubbish day at work and you want to feel better?
Yes. Exactly. No. So, by the way, guys, quick one. You can eat carrot cake.
Yeah. I love carrot cake.
There's nothing wrong with carrot cake. You can eat it and still stay. You can eat carrot cake every day if you want and still stay in shape. But I think everyone got the point on that.
But I think before you can eat carrot cake, though, I think you do have to spend a period of time, you know, putting in the work. Yeah, I know we talk a lot about this, like 80% clean whole foods, 20% whatever you want.
Yeah.
Which, that's how you want to do things like long term.
Mm.
But I think everybody needs to spend a period of time where, you know, they're really putting in the work.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they have to go through what it feels like to really be disciplined.
Yeah.
To later enjoy that flexibility.
Yeah.
But everyone has to go through that.
Yeah. No, 100%. I feel like we're going off the mindset theme.
Yeah, we are
now. one more thing on that, though, from what you just said. I feel like...
Going on some more nutrition now.
a lot of the things I talk about comes back to nutrition. But you you change your taste buds as well.
Yeah, we're definitely going on something.
Mindset, taste buds, carrot cake. When you don't...
Your taste buds do change, yeah.
Yeah, if you don't eat anything like sweet or whatever bad for a period of time and you just eat pure healthy food, you know, fruit starts tasting like fruit is like amazing.
Like frozen
treat.
Grapes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And then you eat the carrot cake and you're like, that's extreme because you're not used to it. Anyway.
And I think just on that quickly, you have to take it out of your diet as well to then bring it back in to feel how you feel afterwards, because you know, chances are, if you eat that pizza or that carrot cake, you might not feel great. You might feel lethargic because it's so good, the taste is worth feeling that little bit of uncomfortableness for a little bit. But if you do that all the time, then you never know. So that's why I always encourage clients that, you know, you have to spend a period of time where you are disciplined and you go through that.
Yeah. No, that's a good one. Get out of
to
it.
Appreciate, and you can make better choices as well then in the future.
If you're constantly eating crap food and feeling like crap, you think feeling like crap is normal.
Yeah.
You don't realize.
You don't. Yeah.
Until exactly what you said. Take yourself out of it. Eat healthy for 3 months, and then come back in and have a bit of carrot cake. And
then you can weigh up if it's worth it or not.
Yeah. So the title of this podcast episode is Mindset / Nutrition /
Carrot Cake.
Carrot Cake. Right. I'm going to actually recap now. See if I can remember everything we spoke about. Setting yourself up for success. Don't be too hard on yourself. You do need periods of the day where getting your body, relax, you know, turn your phone off. Recognize that negative voice inside your head, inside your health, that negative voice inside your head is not you, and you can pull yourself away from it. You can recognize it's there and not follow down that thought pattern. You can take yourself away and be like, nah, I'm not having that. I'm not supporting that. I'm going to do this instead and start thinking positive things, writing down your goals. Okay. Having them somewhere where you can read them twice daily in the morning and in the evening, or take it around with you on your phone like I do. That is going to put you in a good place mentally. And yeah, I think I've touched on most of the things we spoke about.
And enjoy the journey.
Have fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a big thing with mindset as well. If you're having fun and you're enjoying it, it's a lot easier. All right, guys. Out of the wormhole. Back to reality. And thanks for listening. Have a good one.
Bye.